send it. I don't need nobody to pump and prime this over here. God has been good to me. You ain't gotta tell me leave my joy 7 times and run around the building 13 and a half times and God gonna bless you. I already know what God gonna do. He didn't heal my body. When the devil tried to take us out in the car wreck, we begin to say the name of Jesus and every car begin to stop because there is power. Can I get a witness in here? I said, there's power in the name of Jesus. Okay, back to my story. Jezebel, when she was killing the prophets, if you know your word, Obadiah worked for Ahab. But by revelation, I believe that he kind of snuck off and operated in disobedience, which was okay. And the Bible says that he began to hide the prophets 50 to a cave. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And he ministered to them, have you ever read it, with bread and water. Now let's let God bring us on to revelation. That's what we need to do. We need to hide the leaders, not in the natural, but you hide them with your fasting. You hide them with your prayer. Oh, it's quiet in here. You minister to them with your obedience and with your sacrifice. And if the devil try to come in and touch the leaders, you'll be able to say you gotta go to me.
To resuscitate, boom, your obedience level. Glory to God, it comes to resuscitate those things that have you left slip. Maybe through trials, maybe through persecution, maybe even unaware. But God comes to give it back. That is revival. And we come to do that tonight. In these next few days, we pray that we all will be changed forever in the presence of the Lord. I don't know about you, but I'm tired of going to church and it's the same old, same old, same old. The same old people sitting down on the preacher. Y'all know what I'm talking about. The same old 2-3 people getting the same old stale prophecy that they don't do nothing with. Year after year after year after year. The same